can you really heal your body with sound frequencies? Can you really heal your body with sound frequencies? Science is showing that the answer is undoubtedly yes. In today's 10-minute memory hack, we're gonna explore the science around healing with sound frequencies and what that can mean for you and your brain health and future dementia. Go ahead and click that like and subscribe button now to get more of our 10-minute memory hacks every single week, and stay to the end to find out how to use sound therapy for your best health at home. I was on the phone with a client the other day when they talked to me about a watch that projected sound frequencies at different levels that helped with everything from migraine headaches to joint pain, fibromyalgia, depression, anxiety, and on and on and on. Now, I know the power of sound frequencies. My husband's a musician and creates a lot of our binaural beats for our meditations. But to say that sound could actually heal somebody, well, let's just say I was a little skeptical. And in my usual style, I dove in and started doing research, and this is what I found. Sound healing has been practiced for centuries across various cultures, and its therapeutic effects are now being recognized by modern science. Numerous studies have highlighted its ability to promote relaxation and reduce stress and alleviate pain. In one study published by the Journal of Alternative and Complementary Medicine, researchers found that sound therapy significantly decreased anxiety levels in participants undergoing dental procedures. The gentle vibrations and soothing tones used in sound healing stimulate the body's natural healing processes, promoting a sense of harmony and well-being. But sound healing doesn't stop at emotional and mental well-being. It's also found its way into the operating room, revolutionizing surgical procedures. That's right, they're doing surgery with sound. We're all very familiar with ultrasounds. When you have a pregnant woman, they use ultrasound to bounce waves off the baby in the womb, and then they can use imaging to read off those bounced wave signals. Well, now they're discovering ultrasound has many more benefits. Surgeons are now using ultrasound to treat everything from cancer, gallstones, kidney stones, and now they're even testing it on Parkinson's and dementia patients. They do this using a tool that uses sound waves that broadcast through a specifically designed set of speakers to destroy the diseased tissue. You can think of it as using a magnifying glass to focus the sun rays on a piece of paper to start a fire. It burns at the focal point, says Narendra Sanjvi, an engineer who developed this technology. Because the energy level is so high, the tissue gets extremely hot in less than a second, and the cells die instantaneously. The targeted region can be hit with a pinpoint accuracy that rivals the precision of a scalpel and doesn't harm any of the surrounding tissue. By not breaking in or cutting into the skin, there is no blood loss, so transfusions are completely unnecessary. There's much less risk of infection, and patients experience less pain, and recovery time is even reduced. And even better, there's no anesthesia, which we're finding out is extremely bad for you and bad for your memory. I know, it sounds like something out of Star Wars, but it's being used more and more. In Parkinson's patients with tremors at the University of Virginia Health, they found that trial participants saw immediate results and then for 5 years continued to see their tremors reduced by more than 70%, the researchers reported. There were no progressive or delayed complications either. Another study with fibromyalgia patients found that 10 treatments of low-frequency sound stimulation improved sleep and decreased pain. Even better, it allowed almost 75% of the participants to reduce their pain medication. Huge! In another study done on mice with Alzheimer's patients, they used a dolphin's clicking sound at a 40 hertz frequency. Not ultrasound in this one, but just sound. And they also used flashing lights. When the mice sat in a room with both the flashing lights and the sound for an hour a day, 7 days in a row, the amyloid plaques and tau tangles began falling in not just the audio and visual cortexes, but the prefrontal cortex and the hippocampus as well. This was one of the big jumps in the new paper, says Shannon McCauley, a neuroscientist at Wake Forest School of Medicine. These are the learning and memory centers of the brain, and there was about a 40 or 50% decrease in amyloid and tau levels. That's an absolutely impressive feat, and one they're not getting with any other drugs. They're even using sound frequencies to deliver drugs much more effectively now. When you talk about chemistry and you bring a drug into the body, the drug has to bind to something. And in that process, 98 to 99% of the chemical reaction is wasted in heat. But if you send energy via vibration, the amount of energy that's lost in the reaction is virtually none. So if you compare the effectiveness of a chemical signal and an energy signal, the results are very simple. The chemical signal passes 1% of the information, but the energy signal passes nearly 100% of the information. So energy is 100 times more efficient than sending an informational signal using chemicals. Not only that, but because chemicals have to flow through fluid, they may travel at, let's say, 1 foot per second, whereas a vibration like lights travels at 186,000 miles per second. It's profoundly faster. There's really no comparison between the two. Chemicals work, but not anywhere as effectively as or efficiently as energy healing through something like sound. So let's get to how you can use some sound therapy at home. I'm going to talk about a few technologies that you can use at home or even going to clinics nearby, and we have no association with any of these. The first is the Wave Watch. This is the one that my client told me about. She suffered from migraines her whole life. When she started using this watch that comes with over 850 different sound frequencies for everything from kidney stones to GI issues, she said it got rid of her migraine in 8 seconds flat. Now, a lot of the science on which frequencies to use for what ailment is still being discovered, but that made me stand up and pay attention. It's actually what started my journey into researching sound as a health tool. The next is the sound wave technology they actually use with a wand. And this is something typically you actually have to go into a clinic to use, but it's a wand that effectively gets rid of acute pain almost instantaneous. They use it on athletes, and it's so effective that athletes walk out of the clinic with almost no pain in the affected area. Now, one of the easiest and most effective ways to use sound energy healing is to simply meditate or listen in the background to different sounds. Different frequencies will do different things to your brainwave states. Over the last year, I've been trying to get into a dominant theta brainwave state during meditation. I was very surprised when the A note frequency, also called the third eye chakra, and I listened to a third eye chakra singing bowl during my meditation, it got me into a theta state. Another study showed that participants that used singing bowls during their meditation reduced the physical feelings of pain by over 60%. They also found that singing bowls significantly decreased blood pressure and heart rate more than just the silence alone. And of course, this one is super easy to do. I find all sorts of different sounds on YouTube to study to, meditate to, and really just in general use for my stress relief. So great during the day to just put it on the TV in the background and just listen to it or on the computer. So go ahead and find your sound. Like this video and subscribe to my channel to get more 10-minute memory hacks every single week. Happy listening!